Hi guys, it's Mrs. Cameron here. Just showing you guys where to look for your CLT practice test. I've got some practice ready for you guys for the math. So I want us to take a look at practice test number one. And as we're going through here, we're gonna start test. I'd like for you to follow along online with me while you watch this video, and I'm going to skip ahead to section three, section two, and section three. So while you're in here, you can scroll through and follow along. But before we get started with the math, I want you to see your way through the test before you get started with the practice and time yourself. How long does it take you to pick your letter of the day for every question? And then go back to the top. So go ahead and pause the video and do that now. And now that you're done seeing your way through the test, while you're in here also, I just want you to be aware of the formula sheet is right here on the side. So when you need to look up a formula, it's here. And when you're looking at your show questions remaining on entire test, if you did like me and you skipped to the math section, and you're finished seeing your way through the test, it should say 80 right here. You should have an answer for every question. I never want you to leave a question blank on the CLT exam. So we're going here to question number 81. And with this, they're asking, what is the value of B in the figure below? So how many degrees is that angle in the corner? So when we look at this shape, what do you see? B is in a triangle. And the three angles inside of a triangle have to add up to 180 degrees. So angle B is what we don't know. This angle in the triangle is across from a 45 degree angle. So these angles are called vertical angles. And we know that vertical angles are congruent. So if this angle over here is 45, then this angle inside of our triangle is also 45 degrees. And over here, this angle and this angle across from it, since they're across from each other, those are called vertical angles, and vertical angles are congruent. So this angle would also be 55 degrees. So we need to know 45 plus 55 plus how much is equal to 180 degrees. So 45 plus 55, 5 and 5, that's 10. And 4 plus 1 is 5 plus another 5, that's 10. So 100 plus how much equals 180? 100 plus, you got it, 80. All right, let's keep going. Number 82. A scientist is creating a two-chemical solution from the following different chemical substances. Chemical A, B, C, and D. Chemical A can be mixed with any chemical except C. Chemical C can only be mixed with chemical D. Which of the following must be true? So the first one here says chemical A and chemical B can be mixed. I'm going to read back about chemical A. It says it can be mixed with any chemical except C. So yes, chemical A and B can be mixed. Number two says chemical B and chemical D can be mixed. My little stipulations up here, they don't tell me anything about chemical B and D. It says chemical C can only be mixed with D, but it doesn't say that D can't be mixed with other things. So that's a maybe. And then the last one, chemical B and chemical C can be mixed. Well, it says chemical C can only be mixed with D, so there's no way that's true. And our question said, which of the following must be true? The only thing that must be true is number one. So go ahead and enter that. And let's look at another one. Which point, XY, is the solution to the following system of equations? Y equals negative 2x plus 5, 3x plus 2y equals 9. And when we're solving a system of equations, right, what's the solution? You're solving a system of equations. We have three methods that we normally look at when we're doing this. It could be substitution, it could be elimination, or you could solve a system of equations by graphing it. And looking at the two equations that it gave us right here, I'm going to pick my easiest way to solve it. I want you to think out of those three, what's the easiest way for you to solve that system of equations? And hopefully you and I agree with solving by substitution. The reason I like substitution for this particular question is that the y has already been isolated for you. The y is already only by itself. We know in the first equation that y equals negative 2x plus 5. So what we can do is substitute y for y and take this information and plug it in for the other y to give us 3x plus 2. And now instead of y, I'm going to write negative 2x plus 5 equals 9. And we got a little messy, so I'm just going to clear that out. And now I have my 2 outside of my parentheses. What's the next thing to do? Distribute it, multiply it to the other pieces inside. So that gives us 3x, positive 2 times negative 2 is negative 4x. And then 2 times 5 is plus 10. Equals 9. And so I can continue solving for x. What would our next step be? I'm going to combine like terms. So I'm going to get my x's together and I'm going to get my numbers together. How do we get rid of a plus 10? With a minus 10 on both sides of the equation, right? That'll make these tens cancel, and 9 minus 10 is negative 1. And 3x minus 4x is, I see that my negative is bigger than my positive, so it's negative 4 minus 3 is x, 1x or just x. And if negative x is negative 1, then positive x must be positive 1. And looking at my ordered pairs, only C has a 1 for my x value. And I'll catch you back on the next video.